Hi dear students, I am Srinivas sir from Sri Sai Sad Bhavana School. I am going to the 11th lesson, Transport and Communication. Why we need transport and this communication? Yes, to travel from one place to another place, we need this transportation. From anywhere, from your, for example, from the children who are traveling from the villages to the school. Yes, they need the transport system. Otherwise, they can't reach the school properly. The school provide the transport system and the government provide the transport system for to travel to the one place to another place. We are paying for them and somebody have the own vehicles to transport. And what is this communication? Communication means the exchange of the thoughts, exchange of what he has, exchange of thoughts. For example, now what we are doing, the teaching online class, that is also one type of communication. Online class what we are doing is also one type of the communication. Now I will read the lesson first para. Just look at the textbook, page number 77. The whole world today is linked by a wide network of transport and communication. This makes movement of goods possible and contributes to the development of industries and the economy of a nation. The rapid development in the field of science and technology has brought about a great change in the means of transport and communication. This has made it possible for the people all over the world to travel safely and in comfort. Our country has an extensive one network of transport system. All the major means of transport, that is by land, by air and by water, have been equally developed in the last few decades. Yes, the whole world today is linked by a wide network of transport and communication. Yes, the world become very smaller. It become very smaller? No. By this transport and the network, it looks very, very smaller. Very, very smaller or very close we have now. This makes movement of goods possible and contributes to the development of industries and the economy of a nation. Yes, by this transportation, we can transport any goods from anywhere to anywhere in the world. By this, the transportation. By this transportation, you know very well, the transportation consists of roadways, waterways and the airways. By the airways, we can transport anything from place to place. Okay. The rapid development in the field of science and technology has brought about a great change in the means of transport and communication. Yes, we are inventing new things. For example, before 10 years or 15 years, there is no mobile. We have only the radio or papers we are writing and everything. After this mobile, everything was changed. Internet, yes, everything was changed. We can make the call, video call directly with the people. So everything was possible by this, the improvement of the science and technology. Okay. This had made it possible for the people all over the world to travel safely and in comfort. Yes, this thing made all the people to travel comfortably from one place to another place throughout the world. Wherever they want, they will go from place to place with safely as well as with comfort. Our country has an extensive network of transport system. Yes, in our country, that is in our India, we have the network of transport system extensive. That means superb network of transport system. All the major means of transport, that is by land, by air and by water, have been equally developed in the last few decades. That means from after the independence, we are improved all the three, that is land, railway as well as the water. So land, railway also comes in the land only, landways, railways, waterways as well as the airways. Okay, way from the few decades, that means after the independence. Roadways. India has a very wide network of road. They link almost every villages, town and city in our country. The Grand Trunk Road is one of the oldest and largest major roads. It was built by Emperor Sher Shah Suri in 1542. This road connects the eastern and western regions of the Indian subcontinent. It runs from West Bengal across North India into Peshawar in Pakistan. The Grand Trunk Road leads to Afghanistan through Khyber Pass and to Iran through Bolan Pass. The country's road network consists of expressways, national highways, state highways, major district roads and village roads. India has well developed roads on mountainous regions also. The highway connecting Shimla to Leh in Ladakh is the world's highest motorable highway. World's highest motorable highway. Here they are given about the roadways first. India has a very wide network of roads. Yes, have you seen the so many roads? In that they are connecting village to village or village to town, village to city. Like that they will connect all the places. They link almost every village, town and city in our country. I hope now there is no any village without the road. Before that, very very small roads are there. That means even a single bicycle cannot move. Just the people can walk on that road like that. But nowadays they make the wide range of roads because all the village people now they become literate. They know the facilities given by the government. So everyone make the roads to travel easily. Every village, town and city in our country, the Grand Trunk Road is one of the oldest and largest major roads. See, this is the one of the oldest and the largest road, major road, which is one, the Grand Trunk Road. It was built by the Emperor Sher Shah Suri in 1542. See, in the year 1542 itself, they constructed the biggest one road. That is the Grand Trunk Road. What is the name? The Grand Trunk Road. In which cities are connected by this road? This road connects the eastern and western regions of the Indian subcontinent. That means from east to west, it connects this road, the Grand Trunk Road. Next, it runs from West Bengal across North India into Peshawar in Pakistan. Yes, not only this east-west, and also it will move to the Pakistan also, that is to Peshawar. Okay, the Grand Trunk Road leads to Afghanistan through Khyber Pass. Yes, next it travels to the Afghanistan also through the Khyber Pass and to Iran through Golan Pass. See, so many countries are connected by this, the Grand Trunk Road. The country's road network consists of, yes, they are given different names for the different roads. The country's road network are expressways. That means always the vehicles are moving very fast here. It has wide width of the road. The width of the road is very big. One time the 8 vehicles will travel in one road and another side 8 vehicles in opposite direction. Expressways, national highways. Yes, so many national highways are there. State highways, major district roads and village roads. First is express, national highway, state highway, district roads and village roads. 5 types of roads are there. India has well developed roads on mountainous regions also. The highway connecting Shimla to Leh in Ladakh is the world's highest motorable highway. That means it is on the highest peak compared to the sea level. This is on the highest place. Okay, that is motorable highway. There we can travel with the bus or anything. Okay, that is Leh in Ladakh. Shimla to Leh in Ladakh. That is the place. Shimla is one place, Leh is one place. In between them, we constructed a road. Okay, we constructed the motorable highway. Next, national highways. The most important roads in the India are national highways, that is NH. The National Highways Authority of India, NHAI, is responsible for the maintenance and management of national highways in India. The Golden Quadrilateral, a 6-lane highway network, has been developed recently connecting the metropolitan cities like Delhi, Kolkata, Chennai and Mumbai. Yes, national highways. The most important roads in India are the national highways because they connect between the biggest cities. From Kanyakumari to Delhi, one highway is there. Kanyakumari to Delhi. The National Highways Authority of India is responsible for the maintenance and management of national highways in India. Which one will take? NHAI. NHAI. National Highway Authority of India. What is this? In brief, we call it as National Highway Authority of India. Okay. The Golden Quadrilateral, a six-lane highway network has been developed recently connecting the metropolitan city. Six-lane means this side six, see, if this is the road, this side six vehicles will move at a time. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. This side, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Six vehicles move each at a time. Okay, like this, these are the express highways. Recently they made between the Delhi to Kolkata, Kolkata to Chennai and Mumbai. Because these are the metropolitan cities, so these highways will connect these cities. Next, important highways in India, they are given the number National Highway 3. It is a busy freeway and runs from Agra to Mumbai. Runs from Agra to Mumbai. NH4, it is the highway that runs from Thane to Chennai. It passes through Bangalore and Pune and is one of the busiest highways in India. This is, it passes through Bangalore, NH4, that is in the Tumkur Road. Tumkur Road is called as NH4. NH7, it is the highway that runs from Varanasi to Kanyakumari. This is also through our Bangalore only. That is from Kanyakumari to Varanasi. That is what I told now, Delhi, up to Delhi. That is the highway. It will travel from our, when it is here, it is in Bagepalli, near to Bangalore only, Bagepalli to this Bangalore, and through Bangalore only it will travel. That is BB Road, we call it as Bangalore Ballari Road. Okay, so next, it is next National Highway 8, it is the major highway that connects Delhi and Mumbai. National Highway 24, it runs from Delhi to Lucknow. National Highway 44, it is the longest highway that connects Srinagar to Kanyakumari. NH47, it is an extremely busy highway that runs from Gujarat to Maharashtra. It connects, next to National Highway 48, it connects Delhi with Chennai. See, so many highways are there. So many highways are there. Chennai to Delhi, one is there, National Highway 48. Okay, another one, National Highway 7, it is from Varanasi to Kanyakumari. National Highway 44 connects to Srinagar to Kanyakumari. So many highways are there which we will, they have given some important highways only they have given here. 1, 2, 3, between first and second they are not given because they are very small highways. So nearly 48 national highways are there. So this is about the roads. This is about the road transport. You will understand what is the road transport. And we started the, in 1542 itself, the Grand Trunk Road was started by the Mughal Emperor. Yes, Sher Shah. It was built by the Emperor Sher Shah Suri. Okay. Next, National Highway Authority of India, which maintains the national highways. India has five types of roads, that is expressways, national highways, state highways, district highways, and the village roads. Okay, these are the five types of roads in India we have. So this is about the road transport. Next, we'll move to the railways. Next, we'll move to the railways. India has the largest railway system in Asia and the fourth largest in the world. The first railway in India was started in 1853 between Mumbai and Thane, covering a distance of about 34 kilometers. It was started during the British rule in India. Railways are the most comfortable means of transport and hence preferred by travelers all over the country. Yes, India has the largest railway system in Asia and the fourth largest in the world. See, in Asia, this is the largest. When comparing in throughout the world, this stands fourth place. Which one? Our Indian railways. That means that much of vast railway track is there in our India. The first railway started was started in 1853. When it was started in 1853 between the Mumbai and Thane. Between the Mumbai and Thane, covering a distance of 34 kilometers. First they started 34 kilometers. It was started during the British rule in India. When it was started in the British rule. Why they started this one? Because of the, to transport the goods from one place to another place and to transport the army people from one place to another place. So they started this railway system. Next, railways are the most comfortable means of transport and hence preferred by travelers all over the country. Yes, if you travel by the train, it is very comfortable. There is no any shaking or anything. We will travel comfortably and safely for the long distance. Yes, for example, from Kanyakumari to Delhi or Varanasi, it will take nearly 3.5 days. You will travel because it is very comfortable and it will take you to from Varanasi to Delhi in cheap rate, that is lowest cost. The low cost. If you want to go by the flight, it will take more. If you travel by the train, it will take low cost. Large amount of commodities are carried to the centers of industries and markets for sale within the country by trains. Yes, there are special trains called goods trains used for this purpose. The manufactured products are thus made available to every citizen of the country. Indian Railways is divided into 17 zones with their headquarters located in the major cities of the country. Yes, not only the people, the trains are also used for transport the goods also. Not only the people, the goods also transported from place to place, the manufactured goods from the factories, and they are distributing to the places. For example, we are importing the diesel and petrol from the other countries. There is the ports, that is to the Mangalore ports. From there, we have to transport it to all the places. How we can transport? By the vehicles, it is not possible to transport that huge amount of petrol or diesel. So they use the railways. So they use the railways to transport this petrol, gas, cement, everything. They use this railway to transport the goods from one place to another place. For example, in a lorry, you will take maximum of 25 tons to 30 tons if it is a bigger one. But in a train, you will take one time nearly more than 200 or 250 times of lorry. More than 250 times of lorries, because they will use the huge engines. One, not only one engine, they will fix two to three engines for a track, railway track, okay, for the train, and they will transport the huge goods from one place to another place. Okay, Indian Railway is divided into 17 zones. Yes, because this is a big railway system, so here it is divided into 17 headquarters or 17 zones with their headquarters located in the major cities of the country. Yes, in Bangalore also we have one zone. Okay, in that means they have divided into 17 zones to maintain it properly. To maintain it properly, because if it is maintained by one person or one zone, it cannot be maintained properly. So they divided into 17 zones. Divided it into 17 zones. The railways use three types of railway gauges, that is broad gauge 1.69 meters, meter gauge 1 meter, and narrow gauge 0.77 meter. Gauge is the distance between two rails on which the train moves. Almost the whole country is connected through railways, including the hill stations. The railways even cut through the mountain ranges by way of tunnels. For example, the ghat roads cut through the Western Ghats, the Vindhya, and the Satpuras. Next, the railways use three types of railway gauges. That means the distance between the railway tracks. Railway rails. What we call this? This is called as rail. This is called as rails. Okay. First one is the broad gauge, 1.69 meter. The distance is 1.69 meter. Next one is meter gauge, that is 1 meter distance. And another one is the narrow gauge, that is 0.77 meters. 0.77 meters, the distance between the rails. Okay, nowadays we are maximum using this broad gauge only. No meter gauge or narrow gauge are used. In some places only we are using this narrow gauge and the meter gauge. Maximum we are using the broad gauge only. Because if the broad gauge is more, it can fit the length of the engine, length of the bogie, what we call it as compartment, is more. If it is very less, the compartment length is very less, so it cannot fit the maximum people or maximum goods. So if it is a meter gauge or if it is a broad gauge, then we can fix the people or the goods more. Okay, we can carry more people or more luggage from place to place. Gauge is the distance between two rails on which the train move. Almost the whole country is connected through railways, including the hill stations also. Yes, everywhere we have connected with the train. The railways even cut through the mountain ranges by the way of tunnels. Yes, if it is a big mountain is there, they will cut the mountain and they will make the tunnels. What we call it as, for example, if the, like this, they will cut inside this, and they will make the path for the train. Path for the train. Okay. For example, the Ghat Road cuts through the Western Ghats, the Vindhyas and the Satpuras. Western Ghats. Yes, in our Karnataka, when you travel to Mangalore, from Bangalore to Mangalore, you will see these tunnels. Okay. And Vindhyas and the Satpuras. There are different types of trains like super fast express and so slow passenger trains. They provide all comforts within the compartments of the passengers. The super fast trains have limited halts and the passengers can reach their destinations quickly. The Rajdhani and the Shatabdi Express are the fastest trains in India. They connect major cities and important tourist spots. The place on the Palace on Wheels is a luxurious train which promotes the culture of the state of Rajasthan and connects major cities of Rajasthan with Delhi. The Deccan Queen that connects major tourist spots of Maharashtra is also a luxury train. These two trains were introduced to attract foreign tourists. Yes. Then what are the types of trains we are using? There are different types of trains like super fast, express and slow passenger trains. There are three types of trains we use. Super fast, express and slow passenger. They provide all comforts within the compartments for the passengers. Yes, sleeping, seating, toilet facility, lunch, everything they will provide. Everything they will provide. The super fast trains have limited halts. Yes, the super fast trains have limited stops and the passengers can reach their destinations quickly. Destinations quickly. That means if the limited stops are there, there is no any signals or anything, then they will reach the destination very quickly. The Rajdhani and the Shatabdi Express are the fastest trains in India. Which are the two fastest trains? Rajdhani Express and the Shatabdi Express are the fastest trains in India. They connect major cities and important tourist spots. Shatabdi and Rajdhani. Next, the Palace on Wheels is a luxurious train which promotes the culture of the state of Rajasthan and connects major cities of Rajasthan with Delhi. They made Palace on Wheels. That means like so much of luxury, they constructed the railway coach. They constructed the railway coach, how we are sitting in the home, how we are sleeping, dining table, everything they have constructed. Okay, that is called as Palace on Wheels. It is one of the luxurious trains. It connects from the Rajasthan with Delhi. Okay, so some important places. Next, the Deccan Queen, another one train is there. The Deccan Queen that connects major tourist spots of Maharashtra is also one of the luxurious trains. These two trains were introduced to attract the foreign tourists. Because foreign tourists have to know what is our culture, everything. So everything was constructed in these trains. How the Indian culture was. Okay, next, many years ago steam engines were used but now they are being replaced by diesel and electric engines to increase the speed of the trains and shorten the traveling time. Railways are the most convenient and safe means of transport which links almost all parts of the country. Yes, many years ago steam engines were used but now they are being replaced by diesel and electric engines to increase the speed of the trains and shorten the traveling time. First we are, the railway system was started by the steam engines. That means by you heating the water, the train is moving. They use the coal for heating that one. Okay, after that, now they are replaced because the speed of the steam engines is very less. If the load is more, it cannot move. So they are replaced by the diesel engines. Now diesel engines also replaced by the electrical engines because of this pollution. Diesel engines pollute more, so the electrical engines which don't emit anything, okay, so they use these electrical engines. That also, diesel engines are compared to diesel engines, the electrical engines are more fast. Compared to steam engines, the diesel engines are fast. That means steam engines are less fast, diesel engines are okay, but electrical engines are heavy fast, okay, which almost, railways are the most convenient and safe means of transport, which link almost all the parts of the country. That means railways, yes, nowadays for the people who are traveling for the far away distances with low cost, these trains are very, very helpful. Because it will take at a time thousands together people from place to place. If all the people are want to travel by the bus, it is not possible. So for that reason, these railways are very, very useful for the people to travel from one place to another place, not only for the people, are also to transport the goods. To transport the goods, these trains are very, very important. Okay, next we'll move to the waterways. Waterways, the waterways are the oldest means of transport in the world. Indian waterways are very ancient. Our ancestors had made trade relations with other countries through water transport. The Ganga and the Brahmaputra are the major inland waterways of our country. The lagoons of Kerala are also used for navigation. Waterways have also has seen a great development in the last few decades. Modern ships have all facilities with electronic devices and are found safe to travel over the seas. Sea routes connect the major ports within the country and also the ports of various countries. This helps in import and export of large consignments. World trade has now become very popular and essential. Yes, what is the importance of waterways? As compared to the railways, this waterways are the oldest means of transport in the world. Yes, the people use to find the other countries, they use this waterways. Because before the evaluation, all the countries, they don't know where the other country is there. The people will think, we are the only countries on the earth. Okay, after that, they start sailing on the sea with all the facilities. They will travel for so many days and they will find new places. And they also come to know that so many countries are there, so many continents are there. After that only we come to know that there are 6-7 continents like that. Okay. So the waterways are the oldest means of transport in the world. Indian waterways are very ancient. Yes, from the olden days we are using these waterways. Our ancestors have made trade relations with other countries through water transport. Yes, the old ancestors. That means the last generations, what they have made the trade with the people of other countries, people of other countries with water transport, because there is no any transport, air transport or anything like that. So they have to transport the goods with the water only. That means by the ships. The Ganga and the Brahmaputra are the major inland waterways of our country. Yes, the rivers Ganga and Brahmaputra, we use them for the water, inner inland waterways of our country. The lagoons of Kerala are also used for navigation. Lagoons means in the Kerala, they travel from one place to another place because there are so much of sea area is there. So there they use this in the waterways. They use these lagoons for the navigation purpose. Waterways have also seen a great development in the last few decades. Yes, as in the railway or roadways, the waterways also have improved more in the last few decades. Modern ships have also all facilities with electronic devices are found safe to travel over the seas. Yes, nowadays they construct the big ships. Big ships with all facilities. Yes, boating, playing, okay, swimming pool, everything they construct. Okay, with movie theater inside the ships, they will construct everything to travel from one country to another country. It will take nearly some days. So they use the ships because this is also low cost. By traveling ship is also a low cost one. Okay. Sea routes connect the major ports within the country and also the ports of various countries. They make within the country also and from the one country to another country also. This helps in import and exports of large consignments. That means in the sea, we can transport the heaviest goods, the heavy goods with easily. easily we can transport this with the low cost. That is also in low cost. World trade has now become very popular and essential. By this shipways, the world trade become very popular and essential also. Container ships and oil tankers carry cargo, while passenger ships carry people to various parts of the world. Ports are cities with harbors where ships are anchored to load and unload goods. Yes, container ships also there, and oil tankers carry cargo, while passenger ships carry people to various parts of the world. To carry the oil only, that is crude oil. For example, we need oil. We don't have any oil facilities. So from the other countries, we import it. You know, import and export. Import means what we are purchasing from the other countries. Export means we are selling the things to the other countries what we have manufactured. Okay. So we import the oils. We import the oils from the other countries. So for that, we need the container ships and the cargo ships to take some other materials from the other countries. And the people, to travel the people, some ships are there. Okay. Carry people to passenger ships. We call them as passenger ships and the cargo ships. Ports are cities with harbors where ships are anchored to load and unload goods. Yes, in our Mangalore we have one port. Okay, Visakhapatnam, Mangalore, Cochin. These are the ports of our India. The major ports are Kandla, Mumbai, Marmagao, Mangalore and Kochi on the west coast of Tuticorin, Chennai, Visakhapatnam, Paradip and Haldia on the east coast. That means on the west coast as well as in the east coast, we have the ports. We have the ports. Okay. First one, the major ports are Kandla, Mumbai, Marmagao, Mangalore and Kochi on the west coast. These are on the west coast. Okay. Tuticorin, Chennai, Visakhapatnam on this Paradip and Haldia are the east coast. These ports are administrated by the Port Trust of the central government. Yes, these are all controlled by the central government. Minor ports are also located at various points and are governed by the state government. Some minor ports, small ports are also maintained by the state government. Different types of ships like cargo, travelers and ocean liners are built in India and used for purposes like fishing, tourism and for carrying freight and passengers. Yes, in our India also, we manufacture the ships. We manufacture the ships, cargo ships as well as the traveler ships and the ocean liners are built in India and used for the purpose like fishing purpose as well as to tourism purpose and also for carrying freight and the passengers. Freight means the luggage as well as the passengers from place to place. I hope you understand up to here. In next class, we will continue the airways and the communication. Airways and the communication. Thank you very much. Have a nice day. We will continue in the next class.